Okay, so Baba Ji, my third question is, which is very frequently asked, even to me, that is there any free will? And if there is, how much free will we can use? And how much free will is there? This is the most frequently asked question, and I think I really need your insight on that so that your audience, my audience, can hear what the real answer is.
Yeah, so this question can be answered at two levels. One is using astrology. We can try to give an answer. There's no answer to this clearly. I mean, there's no rule or sutra for this. Okay. Yeah. And at a generic spiritual level, we can give the answer. So let's give the, at a spiritual level, let's do it first. See, the free will is always there. But the problem is people don't understand what free will is. Free will, when I say free will is there, again, that same principle. Yeah. Free will means the ability to change your situations.
Situations, yes.
That's
yes.
Not free will. Free will is the response to the things that happens to you.
Yep. Beautiful.
So if you talk of free will, if you define free will as ability to change things, you cannot. It's impossible. That doesn't happen. And if you talk of free will as ability to respond to anything that happens in our life, that is always there with you. So now it depends on you. Free will is there or it is not there. You sit down by thinking, oh, anyways, you know, I will. The modern or the Western, you know, this idea, yes, you can do it. You know, you can do it. You can do it. You are all powerful. You are the universe. You are this. You are that. Oh, my God. That is based on this definition of free will. Yes, karlo duniya utthi mein. Yes, because I always see, you know, that that like with, if I compare myself, not in a derogatory sense, but where I was in my school, okay, we were a bunch of 50 students starting under the same teacher, right?
Right.
Then somebody went to IIT, Indian Institute of Technology. Somebody went to Indian Institute of Management. Somebody went to Indian School of Business, Hyderabad, for MBA. Somebody went and did Masters and then did PhD. And I wonder that we were students of the same teacher, right?
Yeah.
Then what is all this? How come somebody becomes, you know, IIT, and somebody becomes, goes into MIT, somebody goes into Oxford, Cambridge? How does that happen? Because that is where our prarabdha is taking us. Okay.
Yeah.
Now that does not mean that free will is not there or we don't have to put efforts. Okay. Now my guru says, you know, for example, if it is there in your karma that you will eat roti sabji today. Okay.
Yeah.
Now, roti sabji is there, but it will not fly in the air and go inside your mouth, right? The roti will not tear itself, it will not mix with the sabji and go inside, right? Yeah. So that you have to do, and Gita also talks of these principles.
Yeah.
Okay. These all questions, these all problems arise because nobody knows the fundamentals of the Gita.
Yes. Yeah.
Yes. So Krishna says, you know, there are many principles. I will not go into this in detail now, but in short, Krishna says, you know, that the same Arjuna is asking the same questions. What Arjuna is telling? Arjuna is telling, oh, actually, how can I kill Drona and Bhishma? You know, they are my elders, you know, when I used to be small and, you know, Bhishma used to embrace me, you know, he's so loving. And in fact, when he was so emotional, he thought everybody is a good person. Yeah. He used to say, oh, Duryodhana, I know he's a bit naughty, but he's my brother ultimately, you see. I mean, Dushasana, I know he's a bad person. He has insulted Draupadi, but he's also such a sweet cousin, you know, he's such a sweet brother, you know.
Yeah.
Yes, everybody is good, you know, because he's emotional. He's feeling that these are my cousins, you know, how can I kill them? You know, what nonsense is this fratricidal war, you know. So Krishna tells him that when you are speaking like this, he says, you are speaking like a fool, murha, because you are thinking you and your actions are the sole decision. I mean, they can decide everything, your actions, right?
Yeah.
But Krishna says, no, it's not like that. You have your own actions and then you have your karma. They have their karma. Okay. So,
yeah.
You can do your actions, but you cannot control the results. That will come via whatever is destined.
Destined. Yeah.
Now, then many people say, okay, so it is destined, right? That I will eat roti sabji today. So anyways, you know, let me just not do anything, you know.
Yeah, it's a very frequently thing happen. Yeah, people think about
it. That understanding violates one of these five principles, which is your ability to act. Okay, and that's what Krishna tells Arjuna, that my dear Arjuna, your duty is not to think of the future or destiny. Destiny and responsibility should never be mixed. Never. Destiny is destiny. Whatever is destined will happen, but you should know, we should not think, oh, anyways, that's in destiny, you know, so why to do? No, we have to do our responsibility.
Yeah.
Responsibility has to be done. Either it is in line with your destiny or opposite of it.
That's a different thing. Yeah.
That's none of your business. Yeah. That is, that God will decide, okay. And there is all this, you know, Daiva, Karma, yes. Daiva means, some people say, oh, everything is divine, you know, everything is happening by divine will, you know, kuch karne ka zarurat nahi, sab apne aap hoga, aise jo hona hai hoga, sab doob marenge, everybody will die one day. No, that is daiva. Another is karma. No, I will do everything myself, you know, kar lo dunya mutthi mein, you can do it, you know, you have all the power, everything depends on you, you know.
Yeah.
But the answer is a mix of both, that we do our best.
Okay.
And the scriptures, sometimes people have a misunderstanding of the Vedic scriptures. They say that Vedic scriptures make you helpless by thinking of destiny. You will find this argument. Many people.
Yeah. There is a big debate on that, yeah.
Yeah, not only Vedic scriptures, they say, yeah, Bible, Quran, or any religious text.
Holy scripture, yeah.
Yeah, they make you very helpless. Why? They say that there is destiny, you know. Destiny means kuch nahi kar sakta. Jo hona hai, hoga. Okay, so that is why we don't like this idea. We will throw this idea out. Ye bahar ho gaya abhi. Now is the new idea, you know. There's no destiny. Everything is BS. We will do whatever we want, wherever we want, however, at any time. Okay. Well, then, well, everybody would have been a millionaire, right? Everybody would have been the most handsome or the most beautiful. Everybody would have been the most intelligent if they would have tried. But why do they don't end up becoming that? Because that is not sanctioned in their karma. Very simple. Okay. So now we should understand that free will means that suppose somebody comes and scolds us, okay, for some good reason or no good reason. Okay. Then what do we do now? Now the free will is there. The free will decide the kriya mana karma. Always remember it. Okay. The Purani baat.
Yeah.
So now suppose somebody comes and says, hey, you don't know to do this, you idiot, you are such a stupid person. And then what do you do now? You also say, oh, you are telling I am stupid, I am not stupid, you are stupid.
Yeah.
Then what you are doing, you are creating another karma there. You are spoiling your Mars, okay?
Right.
You are committing violence, right?
Yeah.
You are hurting somebody, you are doing violence. And then what will happen when the Kriyamana Karma, the Prasna Kundli is made? What will happen? Mars will be in a difficult dignity, okay? Because Mars exalted or Mars in good dignity means good utilization of your passion. Mars in bad dignity means, fights, unnecessary quarrels, okay? Unable to digest the insult or anything of that sort, okay? So then you create another karma and that is another chain now. And in next life, that person will again come, that person will again insult you and you will again insult him back because your programming is not changed. No? So next life, when he comes back, you will again insult. Yes.
Right.
And then after 10,000 lifetimes, again, so it's like a cycle.
Cycle.
If we want to stop the cycle, we have to know how to respond properly to people. Otherwise, we will damage ourselves. And then these remedies and all this will not work. So, free will was there, it is there, and it will always be there.
Yeah.
And how to use our free will properly by elevating ourselves spiritually? That's the answer. Again, the ultimate remedy is also the remedy for free will.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you know about Jupiter, you know, Jupiter is what? Dhi. The word used is dhi. Dhi means intelligence. Free will is what? Using your intelligence properly, right?
Yeah.
So if your Jupiter is strengthened, then automatically you will use your free will properly. You will know what to do when and what not to do when. If you don't know, then you will just do whatever you want, right? Manorathe na sati dhavato bhai. Oh, he blasted on me, I will blast on him. He did this, I will do that. Now, there is another extreme of this. People say, oh, that means you are saying somebody comes and slaps me, I should just sit and, you know, do nothing. You know, kya kare, it's my karma after all. You know, like Mahatma Gandhi said, you know, one slap, then you slap on this side also. Well, we now there is another responsibility. We have to protect ourselves, right? If a person is coming to kill us, it's stupidity to say that, you know, oh, it's my karma after all, let him kill me. No, no. Then the responsibility comes. Again, I'm saying responsibility is your free will. And your destiny is your karma. That don't confuse both of this, okay? Don't try to mix this. Whatever is in your destiny, you should always do your responsibility. Ramayana does not teach destiny, it teaches responsibility.
Abilities, yes. Beautiful.
Yes. Mahabharata does not teach Krishna when Abhimanyu is killed. Brutally, he is massacred. You know, all these seven Maharathis. They brutally massacre Abhimanyu. Yeah? Together. And then Arjuna comes and Arjuna is crying. And then there was a person once, he asked to my guru that, oh, what kind of a person is this Arjuna? I mean, 10 days before Gita suna hai, 10 days back. Gita, what Krishna told? These are all souls. And you understood the Gita. Because at the end of the Gita, what Arjuna says? Arjuna says, Nashto moha smriti labdhva. Tot prasadan mayachuta sthitosmi gata sandeha karishya vachanam sama nashta moha smriti labdha. All my moha is gone. Sara moha chala gaya mera. Okay. But then Arjun is he's crying, right? When Abhimanyu is dead. So that means he is not a very elevated person spiritually, you know, because he's crying when his son is dying. Well, being spiritual doesn't mean we are heartless. It is but natural for any father to cry if his son is killed, right? Every father will cry and the father should cry. But Arjuna did not become disheartened and he did not say, oh, I can't do anything now. Because he knew that, yes, Abhimanyu as my son, he's not there with me anymore. But Vyasadeva came and consoled him that he has attained a higher destination. Okay. And then Arjuna understood that, yes, that was his destiny. And now is time for my free will.
What do I do now?
And he took a vow that this Jayadrath, because of him, my brothers, the Pandavas, could not enter the Chakravyuh. It is because of this crook. And tomorrow, I take a vow that either I will kill him before sunset or I will burn myself.
Yeah.
And then the moment he says this, you know, Krishna gets a heart attack.
Yeah.
Krishna tells to Arjuna, you know, what is your problem? You know, you and your brothers always giving vows, promises, you know, you, for God's sake, you ask me sometimes. Do you know what will happen tomorrow? Tomorrow the entire Kuru army will be there to stop you. Entire Kuru army. And Mahabharata describes, you know, it was 11 miles long. Jayadrath was 11 miles far away from Arjuna in the beginning of the battlefield.
Yeah.
And Arjuna fights so viciously that his horses, you know, that chariot which he has, you know, these are celestial horses. These are not ordinary horses.
Yeah.
The horses become tired. The heavenly horses, they have surrendered. We cannot run now. We are running whole day. And then Arjuna, what he does? He creates a pool. He creates like a, you know, fanciful island. Inside Kurukshetra, he does this. And he takes the horses and Krishna and his chariot there, and the horses drink water, you know, mountains, they roam around. You know. This is inside the Kurukshetra, can you believe it?
Yeah.
And then Arjuna comes out, and then the horses are like, yes, now we are running. So, and then Arjuna also did not say to Krishna, oh Krishna, you see now, you are there with me now, so you must do, you know, apna to.
Right. Yeah.
Toh game hai na, we are toh tag team partners, you know, like WWE. So Arjuna didn't say that. Arjuna was fighting. Whoever used to come on that day in front of Arjuna, he will demolish them. Whoever it is. No consideration. And then finally when he reached, he was this close to Jayadrath, but still this far. Why? Because at the end, all the Maharathis came and they started attacking Arjuna together. Ek saath mein. Attack. And Mahabharata says it was like a cloud of rain of arrows which were falling on Arjuna. And Arjuna was countering those arrows alone. And he did his best 100%. And then Krishna realized that now it is not possible. Now I have to intervene in his karma or destiny. Abhi gaadi aise nahi chalega. Because the Kauravas have broken all the rules. One-on-one fighting is the rule. But now all the Maharathis are attacking him together. And because it was Arjun, he was Savyasachi, the best warrior anybody can have. He was able to counter all of them. But if it was anybody else, they would have been dead in any time. And then what Krishna did? Everybody knows, you know, that's the rest is history. He took the Sudarshan Chakra and he clouded the sun. And it appeared as if it is a sunset. Bingo is, you know, yes, you Arjun, you said you will kill me. You know? And then Jayadrath comes out and suddenly the sun appears. And Krishna gives that famous dialogue in the Mahabharata. Krishna says, my dear Arjuna, it is not yet sunset. Okay. And take your Gandiv and invoke a Brahmastra, combine it with the Indrastra. These two weapons, you combine it, and that is the sun, and this is Jayadrath. Arjuna, shoot. Arjuna shoots, and his head is ripped off, and he goes and falls into his father's lap, and then his father's head blasts. Okay, so Arjuna.
And I think that was one of the curses he had it to as well. His father, Jayadrath's father, right?
Jayadrath's father went to Lord Shiva and asked a boon that, oh, whoever will throw my son's head in the ground, you know, his head will blast. So yes, these are blessings which somebody asks in the mode of ignorance, you know, tamoguni blessings. Any blessing which is in mode of tamoguna will destroy you only.
Okay.
Like Prahlad has had his bua, na? Bua means father's sister.
Sister.
Yes. What that her name was Holika, right?
Yes.
I will, you know, burn anybody and do whatever I want. You know, fire cannot consume me. Then what happened? She tried to burn Prahlad, you know, and then she was only burnt in that.
Ego. Again, the ego.
Yeah. So never confuse free will with destiny. Whatever is your destiny, which you anyways can't change, don't worry about it. Do your best and leave the rest to God. But we need to do our actions, you see. So your answer to the question, free will is there or not? Yes, it is always there. And if you think free will means to change your karma, then there is no free will. Okay.
Beautiful. Babaji, let's come to the fourth question.
Yes.
Which you have actually already mentioned. I wanted to take your insights on the prarabdha karma, but that you have already mentioned in the first question. So we will pass on to the fifth one, which will become the fourth one. So, which is very important to me actually, because a lot of people ask me as well. So let's move on to the last question for tonight. So the question is, how important the mantras are? Do they really work? And also, if anybody does not know many big mantras, what is one mantra they can do in their daily life? So I think you can answer this very well, better than me. So I really want your insight.
Sure, we'll answer this in the next session. Okay.
Next one.
See you soon.
Yes.